So we're going to continue on to the concluding part of the recital. Like I had mentioned, we won't be ending with a traditional dhun or dhuni today. I felt it was really important to conclude with this Indo-Jazz music that has been developing inside of me. Because coming to India, I've been here the last 6-7 years, almost all year round, and devoted myself as completely as possible to the raga music, sadhana with Guruji. You know, being here in the monsoon is important, so you can learn not only the notes or the phrases of the Abhyanti Maharameg, but feeling what it's like to be here. And likewise for all of the other seasonal ragas. And also being immersed in the spiritual consciousness without a break, I found it to be extremely helpful. But within inside me has also been developing my thoughts and my expressions of how this music has entered into me in a way outside of the raga music platform of the traditional rendering. So we're going to play a little bit of that, and it makes sense that it's in place of the dhun, which is generally is coming from folk traditions, but this is my folk music. You think of it that way. This is coming from the soil, the feel of the land that I was born in. Now it's taken on a lot of traits of Indian music because I love Indian music so much, that has become my main sadhana. So having a drone, you can use in a Western music concept, in a jazz creative concept. You can work with other types of percussion. It just takes time and effort of sitting and practicing and having the different instruments and the different environment settle inside of you. Not just mashing it all together, but letting things really find how they can blend with each other. So that's why we're here today, really, because Shoma has invited me to play in this setting with the Sri Khol. And again, the Sri Khol is not a traditional classical instrument, and there's no traditional Indo-Jazz instruments. It's up to us, and it's up to our friendship and our development together. So the Sri Khol for me made a lot of sense, because it is coming from a folk tradition as well, and I hope you'll hear that in our music. And I've played a lot with Sudhir over the years, Sudhir that. And so this music is coming from that bond of just being free together, having conversation. It might go one way, it might go the other, but the thing is we're still having a conversation. And that way it is different than the ragas. And we'll see where it takes us tonight. It can be quite different from night to night, depending on the inner inspiration. But I'll be playing compositions of John Coltrane's, who's a great master who looked to India in 1964. He started reading. He read the Katamrita. He was reading, and I'm not sure. It's not documented in an extremely clear way, but through his associates and associations and interviews, it's very easy to see that he was also immersed in the spiritual consciousness. And that's where his music started to come from. And in that way, it became a groundbreaking movement in the West, a revolution, where the spirit became more important than anything else. And that's what I hope that's what I've been trying to find in myself, and I hope that you can hear in this music. We'll be presenting some of his pieces. Please enjoy. The first one is called Brasilia. We start our journey in South America. And the second piece will come back with the drone and with the Indian elements. It's called Dusk-Dawn. And we'll continue from there. Maybe I'll introduce when we get there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, my guys, for having us. Thank you. Hope to see you again.